Why did Mars, a once vibrant world, die while Earth, its solar sibling, flourished? The answer may lie in the size of these two planets and their associated cooling rates. Mars, the fourth planet from the Sun, was not always the barren red landscape we know today. It was once a world teeming with potential, a place where water flowed freely across the surface, pooling into vast oceans and winding rivers. The possibilities for life as we understand it seemed endless. Indeed, if you were to journey back billions of years, you would find two Earth-like planets within the habitable zone of our star, each with its own chance at harboring life. Planets are warm bodies, their heat derived from the decay of radioactive elements and the initial formation of the planet itself. This heat is trapped within the confines of the planet's body and can only escape through radiation into the vacuum of space. However, radiation is an inefficient method of heat transport. Planets slowly release their internal heat and cool off as they emit infrared radiation. Earth, being larger than Mars, acquired more heat during its formation and has been able to retain it. When a planet's size is doubled, its surface area quadruples, but its volume becomes 8 times larger. Thus, larger planets release heat more slowly than smaller ones. In essence, Earth is less efficient than Mars at shedding its heat. This retained heat keeps Earth's core molten, generating our planet's magnetic field through the complex movements of charged elements like iron. This magnetic field protects our atmosphere from the solar wind, a constant stream of charged subatomic particles from the Sun. Without this magnetic field, our atmosphere would be stripped away, much like dandelion seeds scattered by the wind. Mars, smaller and cooler, could not maintain a protective magnetic field, exposing it to the harsh solar wind. Over time, its atmosphere was stripped away, leaving the barren red landscape we see today. In summary, Mars, once a vibrant world, died while Earth thrived due to their differing sizes and associated cooling rates. The larger Earth retained more heat, maintaining a protective magnetic field and a nurturing environment for life. Meanwhile, the smaller Mars cooled faster, lost its magnetic field and atmosphere, and with it, its potential for life. Thus, size and heat retention could be the key factors in why Mars died while Earth survived. This was Mars's flaw. Born too small, within a billion years its core cooled and solidified, its magnetic field becoming feeble. Without that protection, Mars lost its atmosphere. Without that atmospheric pressure, the water on its surface boiled and evaporated into gas, where it too got caught up in the solar wind and blown out of the solar system. That water has now joined its brethren in the interstellar wastes, never to be seen again. With that, Mars died, along with any hope of life on that world. The notion that planetary size and associated cooling rates may explain why Mars died while Earth survived refers to the fundamental differences in the geological and atmospheric evolution of the two planets. Here's an explanation. 1. Mars is significantly smaller than Earth, with about half the diameter and only about 1/10 the mass. The smaller size of Mars means it has less internal heat generated by radioactive decay and gravitational compression compared to Earth. This impacts its geological activity and ability to sustain a magnetic field. 2. Larger planets like Earth retain heat more effectively than smaller ones due to their greater mass. This slower cooling process allows Earth to maintain its internal heat, which drives geological processes such as plate tectonics and volcanic activity. These processes recycle materials and release gases from the interior, contributing to the maintenance of Earth's atmosphere and climate stability. On the other hand, Mars cooled more rapidly due to its smaller size. As it cooled, its geological activity decreased, leading to the cessation of processes like plate tectonics and volcanic activity. This lack of activity contributed to the loss of its magnetic field, which in turn led to the stripping away of its atmosphere by solar wind over billions of years. Without a thick atmosphere to trap heat, Mars became cold and desolate, unable to support liquid water on its surface. The disparity in size between Earth and Mars, along with their respective cooling rates, offers insights into why Mars became inhospitable, while Earth remained habitable. Mars is substantially smaller than Earth, with a diameter about half that of Earth's and a much thinner atmosphere. Due to its smaller size, Mars cooled more rapidly after its formation compared to Earth. The rate of cooling is crucial for planetary development and maintaining a stable climate over geological timescales. On Earth, the relatively slow cooling allowed for the formation of a robust magnetic field generated by the planet's rotating liquid outer core. This magnetic field acts as a shield, deflecting harmful solar radiation and protecting the atmosphere from being stripped away by the solar wind. In contrast, Mars cooled more quickly due to its smaller size, resulting in the loss of its magnetic field early in its history. Without a magnetic field to shield it, Mars's atmosphere was gradually stripped away by the solar wind, leading to a thin and tenuous atmosphere, incapable of retaining heat or supporting liquid water on the surface. The loss of its atmosphere and surface water contributed to Mars's transformation into the cold, arid planet we see today. The combination of planetary size and cooling rate highlights the delicate balance necessary for a planet to maintain a habitable environment over billions of years. Earth's larger size and slower cooling rate allowed it to develop the necessary conditions to sustain life, while Mars's smaller size and faster cooling led to its demise as a potentially habitable world. In summary, the smaller size and faster cooling rate of Mars likely played significant roles in its geological and atmospheric evolution, leading to its current barren and inhospitable conditions compared to the more dynamic and habitable Earth.